And basically, my parents looked at each other and looked back at me, and they were like, "We need to tell you something." Hey there, it's Izzy. So today I'm going to be doing a story time. I just want to warn you, this one's kind of like personal, so like if you don't want to know that much about me, bye. So I'm gonna tell you the story of how I found out that my mom isn't my genetic mom. This might seem confusing, but I'll explain, like, don't worry. I'm also gonna talk a bit about the process and like what I found out since like finding out about that and that type of stuff. I've been sitting on the story for a while because I didn't know if I was like comfortable telling it, and I didn't know if it was like the right time, or like if I wanted to try to like track down my genetic mom first, or like I don't know. I just didn't know. But basically, I started reading this book. It's called The Most Dangerous Animal of All, and it's about this guy who like tracked down, well, he didn't really, his mom, his genetic mom found him, and he like thinks that his like genetic dad is the Zodiac killer. And just like reading about that, I was like, maybe it's time, you know? So we're gonna try it. Like, this is my second time filming this video because like the first time didn't go so well, so hopefully this one goes better. Anyway, I also wanted to make this video in case there's like any of you watching, like just found out and like you don't know how to process, you don't know what to think, you don't know how to feel, and like I just wanted to tell my story to share with you that like you're not the only one, and like it's okay to feel all of the things that you're feeling. You'll get through it, and yeah. Alright, let's just get into the story. So me and my family, me and my parents were driving back from a trip to my mom's sister's house. She lives about 4.5 hours away. So we usually stop for like dinner or lunch on our way home, just like depending on what time it is. So this specific time we were stopping for dinner, and we stopped at Friendly's. If you don't know what Friendly's is, you're missing out. But it's like an American restaurant, but it's like kind of more for kids, but like I still love it anyways. But it's also, it's like known for it's ice cream. So like if you don't know the restaurant Friendly's, you might know like the ice cream. Anyway, I love it. Like 13 or 14. I can't remember the exact age, but basically like recently, like around that time, I had been talking a lot about like, dad, we share all this stuff in common, but me and mom, like we have nothing in common. Like it seems like I got all my genes from my dad, and like just kind of saying stuff like that, because like my mom and I, like we just don't have as much in common as like my dad and I do. And like, I look a lot like my dad. So like I look nothing like my mom, and I was like, what, like, you know, it's just kind of weird. But anyway, at dinner I like said something else about it, like something like, oh, like I thought of something that we have in common, we both like rain, something like that. And basically my parents looked at each other and looked back at me, and they were like, we need to tell you something. And I was like, excuse me? Okay, I didn't do that. I was just like, okay. In my head I was like, am I adopted? Like, I don't know, because like, backstory that I probably should have already mentioned is that my brother was adopted. And like, they've been very transparent about that, like throughout his entire life. His mom and his grandma have kind of been in his life a little bit throughout the years. So I was like, am I adopted? And they like didn't tell me, like, do my real parents not want me? Basically. So I kind of had like a pit in my stomach. I was like really nervous because I was like, what's going on here? I just kind of thought that like I was gonna find out that I was adopted and that my parents lied to me for 13 or 14 years, and I was half right. I was half right. They told me that my mom is not my genetic mother. This is the part that's gonna get kind of confusing. I'm not saying you're stupid, but like when I've told people in the past, like they kind of don't understand, and like there's been like some bad experiences with this. Anyway, let's proceed. A little more background that I probably should have mentioned again is that I knew that my parents had a hard time like conceiving, because like my parents are older, like they're, my dad's in his 60s and my mom's in her late 50s, like they're older. So like I knew that they had trouble conceiving and that my mom had a really hard time getting pregnant. I also knew that they did IVF treatments, and they told me that that was how she got pregnant, which is not exactly the whole truth. So this time they told me the whole story, which was that my mom's uterus was, like habitable or like a good environment, to like grow a baby, but her eggs, were not. So basically what they had to do was use an egg donor. So if you don't know what an egg donor is, it's the exact same thing as a sperm donor, except with eggs and not sperm. I feel like that's not really talked about very much. And like I didn't really know that it was a thing until like I found out about my situation. And probably because it requires like surgery and not like a cup, if you know what I mean. So yeah, it's just not, like, egg donation is, just isn't really talked about, so if you have any other questions about that, let me know. But yeah, so my dad used his sperm and they used the egg donor's egg and they put it in a petri dish and then put it in my mom. So my mom did carry me and she, well, she didn't give birth to me because she had a C-section, but she gave birth to me, you know what I mean? So she like grew me and everything, but it's just not with her genetics. So the first thing I said to my parents when they told me was that they're still my parents. They raised me, like this information doesn't change anything. Mostly because I just didn't want them to like feel bad. Because like that's a really, really hard thing to find out that you can't like have a baby when you really, really want one. At least with your genetics. So, you know, I just wanted to make sure that, that they knew that. But in my head, I was actually really, really overwhelmed and, like, angry, honestly, because it took them 13 or 14 years just to tell me that, and, like, that's 13 or 14 years thinking one thing and, like, not knowing the actual truth, which is really shocking and like hard to come to terms with. The thing that hurt the worst was that my brother, as I told you, he was adopted, and he knew like literally since I could remember, but I didn't get to know until I'm a teenager, like, or a tween. So that like was really hard for me to accept. Just because, like, they did it one way for him, they did it another way for me, and I just kind of felt like, why couldn't you just do the same thing for both of us, you know? After that, we were just kind of, like, talking a little bit about it, and, like, I asked them who knows, and they told me they only told 4 people. Those 4 people were my dad's parents, my mom's mom, and one of my mom's sisters. My dad's parents and my mom's mom were all dead. So that leaves me 1 person, other than my parents, that knew. And, like, it's whatever. Like, there was nothing I could do about it. But it just, like, kind of felt like, so no one knows, like, who am I supposed to talk to about it? Like, because I wasn't really sure, like, if I wanted to tell people. I'd rather, like, talk to people who knew about it first so I could, like, get my feelings straight and, like, get myself in order or whatever. But yeah, that wasn't really an option. I was just kind of sitting there thinking, and eventually I asked, you know, the question we're probably all wondering, like, who is she? And, like, again, I figured they'd just tell me because, like, my brother knew his grandmother and his mother, and, like, had a relationship with them, so I figured, like, they wouldn't care, you know? But they told me that it was a closed file and that the, agency had shut down, so there was absolutely no way of me figuring out who my genetic mother is. And if you know what, like, a closed adoption is, it's, like, where the person decides that they don't want, like, their baby to know who they are, to, like, be able to find them or whatever. So it's, like, kind of, like, the same thing. So now I'm just gonna go into, like, a little bit of a mental health rant because, I just wanted to warn you because if you're uncomfortable with that kind of stuff, just, like, skip ahead or click off. So after I found out all of this information, I kind of went through an identity crisis. And I know you're thinking, like, you're only 13 or 14, you don't know who you are anyway. Well, I knew who I was at the time, and now I got this information that told me that half of who I was, I didn't know. So, yeah, like, I'm a lot different now, but, like, at the time, like, I was who I was because of these two people, and now one of them is not, like, my genetics. Like, who am I? Like, I didn't know who I was because I didn't have half of my genetics. And that might not really make sense to you, but that's how I feel about it. But, anyway, at the time I was kind of dealing with a lot of anxiety and, depression, and, this made it worse. In short, it made it worse. I didn't really talk to anyone about it, for a while, and when I did, I ended up going to therapy. In general, I feel like I'm kind of good at, like, pretending that I don't have emotions, even though I do, and, I don't really know what I mean by that, because, like, obviously I have emotions, but, like, I'm kind of monotone a majority of the time, and, like, I have a straight face a majority of the time, and, like, if I don't want someone to know what I'm feeling, I'm pretty good at covering it up. That's kind of what I mean. Learning all this kind of came with a lot of heartbreak, to be honest, because I know that she was doing a good thing, but in turn it made me, not feel great to find out. Anyway, the worst part was knowing that, like, I had no information about who she was, like, what she looked like, what her genetics were like, anything like that. Like, all I knew was that she was around the same age as my parents because that's what they told me. That's what they remembered from the file. So a lot of the questions I had were kind of like, what would it have been like if my genetic mother was my actual mother? Like, what would my life look like with her instead of, like, my family? And it's not like I want a different family. That's not the case at all. It's just, like, that's the kind of things I was thinking. Like, honestly, that's what I was thinking. And then, like, also, what does she look like? What do I have in common with her? Do I look like her? Does she have kids? Like, would you even want to meet me if I found her? I'm not gonna lie to you, I still have a lot of those thoughts to this day. But the truth is, I might never find out. And I think maybe that's okay. I think it was my 17th birthday that my mom finally told me that they kept the file with the information about her, and she gave it to me and let me read it. So I was learning all of this information that I wanted for so long, but it didn't get me closer to knowing like who she actually is. It's just answers on a paper, you know. At this point, I'm gonna just read a little bit of that file just for like record. Okay, so at the time she was 29. She's white, obviously, 5'5". She had brown eyes and dark blonde hair. She was engaged. She's Irish, Catholic. She had 3 children. Two girls and a boy. She had donated eggs previously. She has a sister and a brother. And then I just wanted to read this last page. It says, if you could pass on a message to the recipients of your eggs, what would that message be? And she wrote, I will pray that all goes well for you and that you will have the beautiful child that you have wished for and enjoy them because they grow up way too fast. It's hard like reading that because it's all so nice and like she seems like a nice person and she was just trying to like help people and like I'm glad she did, but I just have no way of knowing like who she actually is, and it's just hard. For me, one of the hardest parts is that she's not my mom. She has absolutely no connection to me, and except for the fact that I have her DNA. When it's adoption, your birth parents are your birth parents. Like, they conceived you, like, your mom gave birth to you, and, like, they're connected to you, but when it's like this, there's no connection. Like I said, it's not that I want a new mom, but it just feels like there's no reason for her to want to know me. And, like, it just kind of, like, knowing that she had kids is, like, I have half siblings, and like, I may never know them, and even if I found out who they were, would they want to know me? I don't know. I watched a video about someone who found her genetic dad through Ancestry or one of those sites, so I think I'm going to try to do that. If you want, I can make a video doing that and like getting my results and whatever. So let me know. But for now, this file is all that I have. And even if I do that, it doesn't mean that I'll actually find her. And if I do, it doesn't mean that I'll actually ever meet her. So that's my story of the time I found out that my mom is not my genetic mother. If you have any questions about egg donation, my story, the process, like anything like that, just comment down below and let me know. And if you have a similar story, like comment down below too, because I want to hear it. Just like I don't want you to feel alone, I don't want to feel alone either. Like, let me know. I'd love to hear that. I just think that it's like really interesting. So yeah, I guess that's it.